So we are back with page one. As you can see, I already matted this page. The size of the paper that I matted with is 10 and 3 quarters by 10 and 3 quarters. Both are the same. And the other thing that I did, because when we are going to add this, is going to be quite bulky, just to make sure it stays closed, I added four magnets here and here. You can hear it probably closing. Can hear the magnets. Just to give you a quick measurement to see where exactly I put the magnets, this would be here. So it's around, let's say, 2.5 inches from the bottom. And around 1.5 inches from the side, so this will measure. This will be 2.5 inches from the top, and 1.5 inches from the side. And this, you put them on top of this, and then you glue them on this side. So now let's finish the, as you promised. Let's finish. Let's put this on the side, and let's finish the frames. So as you can see, I already glued the pictures inside the frames. And I decorated the frame up here with the same paper from the background. This piece measures 3 7/8 by 3/8 of an inch, and this piece measures 5 inches by 3/8 of an inch. Before we apply the frames, these are the wipes to clean the transparency tape. We are going to make frames for this, and for that I chose a paper that looks a little bit like wood, this paper, and it goes well. Also, it goes well with the paper that we use for the background, but I wanted something plain since the background paper is a little bit busy. So let's see. We have to measure these pieces first. So this is 6 inches. So that means we are going to cut a piece of 5 3/4 by, this is 4 by 3 7/8. So let's cut first the 5 3/4. Five and three quarters. Okay, this on the side by 3 7/8. 3 7/8. Let's double check. So this piece measures 6 inches, so 5 3/4 by 4. So three. Oh, I'm sorry. See, good thing I remeasured by 3 3/4, because you are making the frame 1/4 of an inch smaller than the size of this piece. So this is 4 3 3/4. Three and three quarters. Let's put this on the side and let's measure the other piece as well. So this one, let's measure on the long side first. This one is 5 1/8, so it's going to be 4 7/8. Let's cut that 4 7/8 first. 4 7/8 by 3 3/8. 1 2 3. Yes, 3 3/8. So it's going to be 3 1/8. 3 1/8. Okay. Let's put everything else on the side. Okay, I'm going to ink. And you see me in this case, I don't ink like this because I don't really want black here. I just want black to just to cover this side. So that's the reason why I go like this quickly. Now I have to tell you that this will cut in your sponge, so you may find yourself changing your sponge more often than usual. We are done for the time being. We are going to get our punch board and we are going to move this to a quarter of an inch. Quarter of an inch and a quarter of an inch. Just double checking. Quarter, yes, quarter of an inch. And now we are going to punch at a quarter of an inch. Okay, same with this one. Okay, let's put this away. Great. So let's double check, see how it looks. Yes, it's exactly what you wanted. As you can see, it's gonna look really nice. Let's double check the other one too, before we go any further, to make sure that, yes, it's absolutely beautiful. So now let's cut. So now we are going to make sure we are matching on this side of your trimmer at a quarter of an inch. A quarter of an inch. The other side. Quarter of an inch. Okay, now here. And here. Something doesn't feel right. Okay. And done with this piece. Put this frame on the side. Keep this piece, you might make use of it. Okay. Now we are going to also use two ink inside it. Again, I didn't change the blade, shame on me. Okay, let's ink it inside the frame as much as you can. Actually, what a good thing here would have been a Sharpie marker. And I know I have a black Sharpie marker somewhere. And I might just look for it. Hate myself for not changing the blade now. I forgot to change the blade again to the trimmer. It's okay, because the ink will cover the white. Okay. Just making sure it looks nice, and it does. Now my fingers don't look nice anymore. Okay, so I'm going to use an eighth of an inch tape to password on the back. Let me see, I'm trying with the quarter first. Let's see, do we have any? Nah, it's gonna go over. When I apply tape on a piece of paper, I like to do the opposite sides, one side and then the opposite side. So I'm going to apply the tape, and now I'm going on the opposite side to apply the tape over there as well. And try and apply them as close to the outer side, okay? So I'm applying the tape very close to, so close to the outer sides of the frame. And you know what, before we glue them down, I'm gonna give you the measurements again. But once again, it all depends on the sides, on the sizes of these pieces of the frames. And whatever this size is, it's a quarter of an inch less. Okay, so let's take the smaller one. So we are going to apply this over here like this. So let's remove the double-sided tape. Where is my? Oh, come on! Don't you love it when you can't find your tools? Oh, here it is. Okay. Take your time, don't rush. You want to have a beautiful project. Okay, this one is done. Next frame. Once again, take your time. There is no rush. Get rid of this. So what's left now to do is to actually apply these transparencies, these frames, on top of your pictures. Okay, now I have already applied tape on both of them. Apply tape like this, and actually on this one I applied the wrong tape, ha ha ha, because I was supposed to apply tape up here and up here. Oh no, sorry, no, yeah, I applied it the wrong way. So I'm going to try and remove this tape now. Okay, garbage. Garbage. So we need to apply this here, so therefore we need to apply glue on our frame to match these flaps. Same goes for this one, we have to apply glue on the frame to match these flaps, which is this. So since this was wrongly done, we are going to apply glue again. So in this case I'm going to need glue here and here. This is 3/8 of an inch tape, and I'm going to apply it as close to the edge of the paper as possible. Burnish it so it sticks down well, and let's apply it. We're gonna do one side first, then I'm gonna clean up the inside, and then I'm gonna glue the other end. So in order to apply it, I'm going to put it as close to the score line. So see here, we have our score line here, right under the score line. Okay, this cannot interfere because they need to go flat when we close the page. So right under the score line, like, I'll show you right now, and done. Okay, we'll have to burnish it, so open it up to burnish it. Okay, and let me show you. See, this is where this is the square line. I'll show you with my nail, and right under the score line, the bump from the score line, is our frame. So this is a time when I'm going to clean the inside, because it will be very difficult to get on the inside once the frame is closed. So I'm gonna take one of these lens wipes, and I'm going to give it a good clean. Okay. Oh, this is great because it's alcohol based, so I can clean my fingers a little bit too. Okay, it's just that they dry very quickly, these lens cleaners. Okay, so now we're ready to glue it on the other side. In order to do so, we need to do it in this in a flat position, because we'll have to make sure that we are actually allowing the frame, I mean the entire picture frame, to go flat when the page is closed. Okay, so what I'm doing, as you can see, this is the half an inch. This half an inch here, it's flat with the surface. I'm gonna push it down, and then push from the other side down. At this time, this half an inch, the one right after the picture, is up. So this is what I'm going to bend, and then I'm going to glue it down. So see? Okay, so try not to touch the inside of the transparency piece. So I'm pushing it down as much as possible. I want this to stay as flat as possible. And done. And play with it. Make sure you get it used to bend in all directions. And this is one picture frame. Let's do the same on the other side. Let's take our piece. So glue it right under the score line on that bump, under the score line. Put this flat down, as flat as you can. Open it up, burnish it. Where's the other one? Okay, now it's time to clean it. Where's the other lens wipe? Here. So at this point, this half an inch is going to stay flat, while the other flap is going to be all the way up. So you're going to have half an inch and half an inch. Okay. So we are going to remove this piece, keeping that down and pulling this down, and try and stay as flat as you can. And done. Burnish it. Burnish it in the opposite direction too. So this will be like this. Like this. So now we have to put tape down here. And we have to make sure that this entire half an inch is covered in tape. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put 3/8 from one side and then 3/8 from the other end. I'll show you what I'm talking about. So first I'm applying 3/8 as close to the base as possible. Okay, I'm going to break it here and now apply again 3/8 on the other side as close to the base as possible. Okay. I've just realized I need two more wipes in order to clean the front, so I will be right back. Sorry about that, I'm back with the wipes. So now it's time to clean the outside of the transparency sheet. And try your best not to touch it too much. You can still clean this once the pop-ups are up, but still, if you, this is the best time to do it, this will be its flattest. Ok, Okay. So now we have to also apply a quarter, to apply a tape over here. Don't throw away this piece because we will need to cover one side while we are gluing the other side. So again, as close as possible to that score line, we need to cover the entire area. I should have cleaned up the transparency after I was done with this, but I didn't now. So. Okay, and put this back to cover the glue from here. Okay, come on. You know what? Forget it. Doesn't want to stay. We can start gluing and we'll apply the other one before we glue it down, because first we are going to glue the longer side. Anyway, so take it. Let's open our piece. And the trick here is that, see how this line, right, has to fall exactly, I mean this score line here has to fall exactly on the score line of our page. So we are going to press it like that, okay, that where you can see the glue part, and I am going to to glue the longer side first, because I want to make sure it's not going to come out of the paper when we close the page. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to match as much as possible, and the closer we are to the end, the more it will open. Okay, so I am going to probably like this, and I'll give you a measurement. Where is my ruler? Okay, so this sits, so the corner of my frame sits at, what's this, an inch and a quarter from the top of the page. An inch and three quarters from the top of the page. Okay, let's see. Yeah, an inch and three quarters. And the other end sits exactly where my matting is ending. Okay, so what I'm going to do now, oops, it moved a little bit. I'm going to remove this piece. Am I doing this correctly? Yes, I hope. I'm going to remove this, keep it in there, and I'll go and close the page. And make sure that this core line, see the corner of your frame, sits on the score line of the page. Okay, and now you'll feel it, move it a little bit, and that's okay. And now close your page and press down. Almost there. So now we have to do this side, and remember we still need to add some tape up here. So I'm going to remove this part. Where is the tape? I'm going to apply tape so that it covers the entire. And as you can see, the picture faces you when you put it on the page. Okay? Okay. Burnish it down. Now remove it. I'm trying not to touch the transparency plate here. And now close your paper. And burnish it. Same on the other side. We fill it, burnish it. And now, ta-da! Look how beautiful this is. There we go. If you have something that you can go in there and burnish down even better, but my this is too wide. I wish I had like half an inch or even a skinnier to get the paper used to sitting here. Try and burnish it as much as you can. That's why when it comes to pop-ups, it's very important when we do the score lines to score, to then play with those score lines in both directions. I really hope that this dry glue is going to hold in here. I've seen pop-up artists who are using double-sided tape. Others use wet glue. I'm not a big fan of wet glue because with this one, if you are outside the boundaries, it's going to create a problem. So there we have it, our pop-up frames. So let me close. It stays closed because the magnets are helping too. Don't worry that it looks buckled up here. Not to worry about that. Once you cover this page and you start creating more, this will no longer be visible. And let's be honest, even pop-up books, they look bulky and, you know, bulgy, etc. And it's normal. It's a pop-up. I'm just trying to burnish this as much as I can here. And there we are. So remember, this is the flap that we added at the beginning of creating page one in the other video. So make it more flexible, play with it to get you used to being a pop-up. And there we have it. I'm gonna go offline and I'm going to decorate the rest of the now I don't know where are the pictures. I have more pictures. Basically what I'm going to do now, on one side I'm going to use pictures of his family, and on the other side I'm going to use pictures of her family. It looks really, really nice. There you go, guys. Let's close it again. Oh, and the other thing is, whatever you are going to decorate now, try to be flat, because when this closes it might catch. Or if you want to use how do you call it, 3D decorations, make sure that they are nowhere where when you close the page is going to hit into these frames. So that's my other advice for you. I'm still gonna burnish this a little bit more, but this is the pop-up frames, and I'm trying my best to do like a pop-up element for each page. We're not gonna be able to use too many pop-ups on one page because otherwise it's going to become too bulky. But and I'm going to leave this side black. I'm fine with that. I can live with that. Yeah, there we go. I think I showed you this too much. don't get bored. So I'll be back and I'm going to show you how I decorated the rest of the page. I don't know where I did those pictures right now. They are somewhere around here. My place is already started getting messy from this project, disorganized, and I don't like it. So yes, that's it. And for the front of the page, what I want to do is to put this, and I showed you earlier, to put that family tree picture. Let me see if I can quickly find it now. Oh, I thought I had it. And if I'm going to add a little bit more pop-ups, I'm going to, of course, show you how I did it. Because, for example, I really like this here, where it says family, the link to your to our past, and the bridge to our future. And because this paper collection comes with 2 pages each, what my intention would be to cut these two and also make them as pop-up on this page, to open exactly the same like the frames, but not in a frame, just simple pop-ups somewhere here. You know, I think that would be nice, but it also depends on how I'm going to whether or not it's going to be enough room, because I also have to add the other pictures. So that's an idea. But if I'm going to decide to make a pop-up out of this label, I'm going to show you how to do it. And as I was saying, to come back to my original idea, on this page, I would like to add I don't know where it is now, that the picture with the family tree, where his mom can easily write down the names of the family members. Don't you just love it when the pages you're looking for are no longer there? Seriously? I mean, it's 2 pages each. Where are they hiding? Oh, yeah, of course. Murphy doesn't sleep. The end. So, what I'm going to do, I'm going to make this page to be 11 by 11. And to do so, I'm going to have to cut half an inch, half an inch, half an inch, and half an inch. Just for curiosity, I want to see if this is, oh, this is perfect. Actually, it's more than, I wanted to see if the distance, so I don't cut into these labels, if the distance from the end of the labels is half an inch or more, and it's actually 5/8, so that's great. So I can easily cut half an inch here. Here, it doesn't really matter. They're not going to know how big this tree was. Let's see, can I cut half an inch here? Yes, but it's going to be so close to the edge. What can you do? And then half an inch here, it will mean that. No, I'm good. You know what? Maybe I can cut an inch from here so I don't have to crop from there. No. But what I'm going to do, I'm going to crop 3/4 probably from this side. 3/4 from this side, so like this I only cut 1/4 from here. So like this, this last box is not exactly at the end of the page, so to speak. So like this is gonna be to there, and I think that's gonna be fine. Let's see again, 3/4 from here. Yep, it looks fine. You know what? Let's do it now. Just in case you still have this collection around. So I'm going to cut half an inch from here. Half an inch. Okay. half an inch from this side. Perfect. Now only a quarter of an inch from this side. Quarter of an inch. And here, first I'm going to remove this white part, and after that I'm going to cut the three quarters. So let's remove this white piece and the three quarters of an inch measure from this onwards. So half an inch, three quarters. Let's see how it looks. I'm gonna go a little bit under three quarters. And this should be just fine. Let's see. Yep, so this will sit right here. Oh, still too big. Oh God, yes. No, it's, oh yes, because we want to make the page. So I'm gonna, yeah, 10 and 3 quarters by 10 and 3 quarters. I was thinking 11 by 11. Okay, so in that case, I'm going to crop another quarter of an inch from here, from the tree side. Because I need 10 and 3 quarters, so a quarter of an inch from here. This solved the problem. The problem is here now. I can't crop off too much. Let's see if I crop a quarter of an inch. No, you know what? I'm gonna do an eighth and an eighth. Let's see. So that's a quarter right there. I'll have to guess at 1/8 of an inch. This will definitely cut. I don't want that. I would rather take another 1/8 from the bottom. So I'll still end up with that box so close to the edge. But I'd rather do that. And 1/8. Okay. I forgot that our base pages are 11 by 11, so therefore, when you make the entire page, you need 10 and 3 quarters by 10 and 3 quarters. Alright, so now this looks fine. This will look beautiful here. So this will be the part where the mother is going to write the family tree. And here where they are getting married and engaged. And I'm going to put pictures, like I said, on one side is going to be his relatives. And on the other side, on the other page is going to be her relatives. Alright, see you in the next video. And thank you for your patience and for hanging there with me while I'm planning this entire album in my mind. Bye-bye.